Operational report. Lots of submarines detected. The anti-submarine warfare must be really, really heavy over there. Aircraft. Right? De Haven cannot repair anymore on Hajima. We knew that. Submarine detection. Gil credit. Crash. Recon over the Japanese army. Kill credit. Crash. Supplies moved to Baton Island. Uh-oh. Jack. Yeah, she's damaged. She's trying to creep back in. It's flooding. Repairs complete. Kanazawa expands. Well, that just gives me more points when I capture it, I hope. Oh, and another upgrade. See, the factory upgraded last turn, and it upgrades again to, this is the final one, P-38 Juliet to P-38 Lightning, Lima. And the Delta One Mitchell's upgrade to Juliet 11s. Ah, the base force, something has upgraded. We better look at that. We have aircraft in the pool returning. All these PT boats return to service. Great. Defense Battalion takes replacements. That must be on Baton Island as well. We sank a submarine, right? And all these landing barges. But all these landing barges, guess what? 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 4, about, there's about 20. That doesn't even match the cost of my submarines. We lost today. We lost. First order, better take a look at the Baton Island. We have the 1st Marine Defense. They took replacements. Good. I forgot. Look, these guys actually upgrade with radar. I didn't need to drop an air base on here, but I didn't upgrade them. Son of a gun. Oh, well. All that work. But hey, look, they upgraded. Oh, even without 20,000. So I guess they were close enough to the command, or they got it from Manila or whatever. Who cares? They upgraded. Actually, they may not have upgraded. Either way, they've upgraded what I need them to upgrade. They should still be taking squads, but they haven't got any squads, so I'm going to turn off the upgrade, and I'm going to turn on the replacement so that they get aviation support, motorized support. But hopefully, well, I think with replacements on, because this is now, they're expecting rifle squad 44, 1944 squads. They'll probably be taking rifle squads, but that's okay. We can afford to lose 12 more. Check the ships. Oh my God! Which one was Jack? Jack was flooding. That's right. So now I've got to check through all these submarines to make sure that they. I don't. Can anyone tell which ones already have orders to return? No one can. So guess what I'm going to be doing? Yep, clicking on every mother loving submarine to make sure. We'll also check for torpedoes to make sure that the ones who engaged still have torpedoes. All the submarines still have sufficient torpedoes to continue the mission. No other ships seem to have collided. Let's take a quick look at the victory points. The 86 enemy aircraft destroyed for 21. That's barely 4, not even 4.5 for 1. Today, we lost. Singapore. We took some raid, I think. We managed to get a few, but they also managed to damage a few more of my Mustangs. So we're back in the crapper, so to speak. But we still have aircraft. They're damaged. They're being repaired. We got kills, which is what is important, right? Training school. Now, the VIX, the Bowfighters, we sure would like to upgrade to something else, to 21, but I don't want to take them out of the line until the Indians return. We left Miri. We just started sailing off. I guess that's it. We're going to head up to Manila, because at Manila, rather than dicking around, it could take forever. Looking at how long it took tried to load those things, it could take forever to try to unload, so we may as well go for the biggest port in the region, unload, and get the hell out of here. We're going to let the other guys, the amphibious vessels, take over to recover the rest of these jagoffs. We're still stuck in Samarinda. We'll load at... oh, we have the Fireflies here. Okay. Oh, tanks unavailable. Oh, for the love of God! Oh, man. Okay. Well, I don't care how tired you are. We're going to try to fly out to, I guess it would be Davao. Yeah, we can't get any further than that. Davao it is. Oh, that's going to be terrible. Okay, let's see. Let's hope. Fingers crossed. Don't crash. Don't crash. Don't crash. Don't crash. Don't crash. Don't crash. Ah, no crash. Okay. Because if it crashes and we take out all the base forces out of Davao, that means there's nothing left to to fix the aircraft. So let's make sure she's on rest. No training. No training. Your escort, 100% guaranteed rest. No accidents. No late night on the town. Seafire. Let's see. Where can we transfer you? I'm sorry. Where's the rest of your guys? Your brethren? Oh, they're all the way up at Manila. Good for you. Okay. Join them. So now we're going to try to see what we can load at Tarakan. I'm still keeping the... I don't need these bow fighters yet or Mustangs, so I'm keeping them here. Just letting them fly and collecting some experience. Okay, we're loading all the Aussies at Tarakan. No fuel, no supplies. Verify. Woo! Look at... Oh, man, that's way too many, isn't it? Of course, there's no... We don't have a button here that says, can we go minimum? Nope. Guess what we're doing? Yep. Doing it all manually again, because that's how much fun this game is. Just to click and click and click and click and click. Okay, so I'm just going to... This is Balik CVE. Wow. There's only... Okay, you know what? It's just easier. Piss off. Just disband. Oh, we can't disband it. Oh, for the love of God. Oh, no. Gonna have to click it. Watch. Gonna have to put them into the base one click at a time. Oh, for the love of... Okay, with all the unloaded transports in the base, we form one. We're gonna have... Oh, Christ. Nope, we're gonna transfer a bunch more. Right? And let's see. If the AI is able, we'll go load troops. Turn off, and now we can say verify. Oh, add, get more ships. Okay, get more ships. 19 ships added, but still insufficient, right? Even though the load safety factor says 140% and 120%, supposedly, let's see, the minimum, yeah, right? I'm going to trust it. I'm going to say use all the ships. 148, that's twice as much as we need. I'm going to say, go ahead. Let's trust this one. And then we'll have everyone follow it. We'll swing around and see what we can pick up at Brunei. At Davao, we pick up the rest of the aviation engineering battalion, but we only managed to pick up one of these base forces and have to one and a half or one and a third. So we'll have to come back for another round. Looks like the Breton group is already coming back to finish off the job. Okay, we're going to take this one. Why go all the way around that? Let's just go coastal. It'll be a little bit... Oh, cripes. Oh, man. Why is it so difficult, huh? Why so difficult? Let's just use a waypoint. Let's go right here. Right. On Luzon, we have destroyed one unit here. A few more have moved in. Okay. We'll check the soft. Getting a little bit more experience again. Put them into combat and attack. Now we've got all these other ones are moving are marching across, trying to march into the hex as well. I think we've got enough here to destroy the enemy. I would love to share the experience, but the time it takes to march in here and then back out and then down there is just prohibitive. So what we're going to do is we're going to take these, we're going to change. We've wasted one day marching towards the enemy. We're going to waste the rest of this day marching up here. Set all to march. Now we got to wonder, there's a couple of engineering units we don't want to march, so we want to set strategic and then drop them back down. Okay, on the attack here, we're also going to set everyone to move. Set everyone to march out this way. We can still attack by clicking on the deliberate button. See, we are going to deliver an attack even as we move to the west. This will give me a head start. Hopefully, if we kill these last three units and we move, we'll move out to here and then get on the good road and be able to move on to the other location. The tanks move very quickly, so they should probably be right out of here within a turn or so. If they don't, under combat mode, they shouldn't be able to leave the hex. Tanks should not be able to leave the hex if they are under combat mode, but we can cancel the move next turn if we have to. Up here, we have a whole bunch, okay, already moving on. They might just get here first and destroy them. With 3,000, I think we should be able to kill whatever's here. I'm going to move the Filipinos over as well. Why not? Everyone's going to share in the death and destruction. Why not? Did I remember saying anything that goes near Baton Island is cursed? Here comes Lexington around the corner. Lexington was supposed to show up around here and then go up around Legazpi and around the other side. But no. Like, Lexington decides to go up to around the north whether I like it or not. Oh, you stupid bastard. Okay. And there's no... What else? We're going to take the coastal route. Guess what? All these guys, you're changing. We're now going to meet. Okay, we're going to form up these guys. We're going to transfer the other amphibious vessels in here. The silver lining of the attacks on the escort carriers is the Baton Island has been given a respite, and they managed to repair a number of fighters, so they're getting back into shape as we build. And we've now dropped another, we've got 4,700. I think I'll probably fly in about 30,000 and then let the transports rest. But it's burning up transports. Okinawa, we've had some attacks. The Corsairs managed to get in. They flew missions, but they didn't get any kills, unfortunately. But they're still going to get... Okay, they're here. There's a little bit of fatigue after flying all that distance. The Thunderbolts continue to score heavily. Look at that. This is just churning out aces. Not aces, but churning out experienced pilots. Look at all that experience. Okay, so we're in good hands up on Nago. Down at Naha. The ships, I guess they weren't attacked. It was just an airbase attack. Now, we had a submarine drop in here, the Pito. This isn't very badly damaged. It's damaged, and I do want it back for repair, but it's not damaged back badly enough that I need it at a forward base to repair. So I'm going to send it back on to Manila, because we got some really badly damaged ones coming in here, and we're going to need that dock space. Okinawa, we've got the Hellcats arrived. We only have 12 pilots. Actually, we have 14 pilots, but two aren't going to arrive for another little while. So it makes these pilots, they'll fly more often, but it also tires them out more quickly. So but we don't have any spare pilots to really give them. I don't want to give them the grid pilots, because it's just night fighting. It's not like the fighters can escort on night fighting. It's just interfering and shooting down and with bombers. So I don't want to give up the good guys to the night fighters. So I'm just going to, they're going to suffer. They're going to suffer for now. Okay, we've had a respite. We've managed to bring back all the Warhawks. They're all in They're all repaired. So at this point, I'm going to pull them out so that we can have a chance to upgrade them to something useful, like Thunderbolts maybe. They're good pilots. They're learning, and they're a little bit tired. So we're going to strap on the tanks, get them into rest mode, show that it's resting, and I think I'm going to head for Manila. Manila already has a squadron prepared to drop them out of tanks. Okay, let's they'll drop back in. What are we going to upgrade them into? I don't want to use other Warhawks. We've got 75. I don't want to use twin engine Lightnings because they're twin engined. Thunderbolts or Mustangs. I've got more Mustangs than I have Thunderbolts, and the Mustangs are just as effective. I hope. I don't know. So we're going to upgrade to Mustang. No. And since we only get them once, we might as well. We're going to load up. Oops. Shucks. They're down here. We're going to load up with as many as possible. Where are you? There we go. We're going to load up with as many as possible. Oh, gosh. But we took out Warhawks. I don't want to put Lightnings back in there because these are twin engine sons of buggers. Got it. I'm going to borrow a squadron from Iwo Jima. They're nice and rested, fresh, ready to go. I'm going to conduct a one ship invasion. The LCVP, I'm going to conduct a landing craft. I'm sending a couple of combat engineers over to maybe not. Well, we'll see. We'll see if they allow me. If we have any combat engineers, we'll send them up to try and capture Okinoerabushima and maybe Tokunoshima as well. Okinawa, or Iwo Jima, pardon me. The surface combat ships, great. We smacked them hard again, came back. I think they're all loaded. I hope they're loaded. Yep, I think they got all an ammo reload. Good. Let's bring the battleship up. We have another spare battleship here. These two battleships, Jersey and Wisconsin, I'm gonna be cautious and not send them, because even though it's a 7, the range is only 1, we should make it. We should be able to bombard and get the hell out of there. Let's not take that chance. The last thing we want to do is get hung up on Chichijima outside of air cover. Oh, here's a replenishment vessel. AO sailed right past, right? AO supposed to come in here and let them refuel. Good. This is 171. Watch. Here's the carrier that we're supposed to... You idiots. This is your air cover. They've already run past you and got... Oh, freaking heck, you bozos. Okay. Can't trust those Navy guys. Here's the transport still unloading. Okay. We're over 2,000 down here. And our ammunition ships, we can take a look and see that... They've got 3,800. Maybe enough for... No. So whatever these guys use up, they'll come back and use them up, and we'll have to send them back down to Iwo Jima. Iwo Jima, we have an ammunition ship has arrived. Let's disband. Oh gosh, we have to go through this rigmarole again. Yep. I don't want to load these guys, so guess what I got to do? Yep, form them up into a task force just so that they don't load supplies. Oh, you stupid. Yeah, how fun is that? Okay, we're back in here. We're going to load tenders. Hello. Now, these tenders are up here. We're going to transfer the half-baked one. Dock and load supplies. We're going to form up a second one. Form tender. Support. This is the... Where is it? All right. We're going to head over. We're going to try to get into Hajima in case it's needed. Every little bit helps. Mick, now I'm going to send it as a transport, because the problem I have with replenishment and support, my experience, I don't know if it's the way it should be, but my experience is when they arrive at a port, they tend not to disband. Instead, they just sit like idiots there and act as targets. So that's my experience, but I could very well be wrong on that. Okay, we're going to repair the LCTs. I'm not going to refuel them yet, just because I don't know what the hell's going on up here. And I'm trying to preserve, trying to conserve fuel in case I have to drop them back into the pool. Oh, here's good stuff. Okay, so we've taken a squadron out of here. That's fine. We've taken a squadron out. We're going to rotate the combat air patrol duties. Good. Next squadron up in line. Yeah, we'll get the Mustang hotels. Good, good, good. So everyone takes their... We haven't been attacked yet. We haven't had to shoot down anybody yet. So we're kind of wasted up here. But that's okay. I'd rather be wasted sitting up here than throwing their lives away. I could be conducting fighter sweeps over here, but why throw away good pilots? The pilots are coming. They're attacking us, and they're jumping onto the buzzsaw and impaling themselves on our bases. So let them come. If they don't want to come attack Iwo Jima, that's fine. Here's what we've noticed up. We've made a detection. The patrol boats over here have made a detection. Where are the patrol boats? Here you go. Patrol. They've detected a couple of subchaser E-boats, escorts. So they could be anti-submarine warfare. Now, this is why we were planning here. Here, these surface combat... Oh, man. You stupid... Oh, we sailed right past, and I totally forgot to drop them in here. Oh, man. You're an idiot. Okay, we're going to sail in here. We're going to disband into the group and retire. There's another... No. We don't want to do that. I don't want to get closer to Japan first, you idiot. Try to stay as far away as you can. Then go if you have to. We also have a surface combat group. These are cruisers. Now, I sent the cruisers to help cover, but also I was going to base them out of Iwo Jima just for this kind of threat. The threat is these sons of buggers. So what I want to do is I want to send a... Let's try it. I'm going to send Boise and a couple of destroyers. Maybe I don't want to send too much because it's too easily detected. So I'm... Okay, we'll form, and it's cruiser. I'll send the Boise. Boise's out of 93 and a couple of destroyers out of 93. Should I... Three or four? A couple of gun destroyers. A couple of these. One, two. The more ships you put, the more exposed you are. So, but will three... Okay. We'll send four. We'll send a maximum reaction, and we'll make sure the float planes are... Oh, God. Now I got to go back and find out. I don't want to use the Seagulls. I want to use the longer ranged. Can anyone tell me which ones easily? No. Not the Seagull. Do we have any longer ranged? Well, maybe I'm stuck. No, I guess I'm stuck. I think these guys didn't get upgraded to Kingfishers before they left. Now, I could send a heavy cruiser, but it ain't worth it. It ain't worth the risk. The light cruisers are still worth a lot of points, so maybe I should have just sent a destroyer squadron. Now, the reason I'm not sending a destroyer squadron... Okay, I'm going to send these. We're going to use a patrol zone here. First patrol zone. I don't want to get too close to those guys. And the second one, I'm going to pull back here. Why am I doing it this way? And the third one, I'm going to put on the base, and we'll refuel. And when we get to the third one, we want to have it linger for linger. I want it in air cover. Now, hopefully, it'll come up here, intercept this damn thing, and then come down to the second patrol zone, and then back home. The reason I want to do this is I'm sending a cruiser because the cruiser has its own search plane. which will help direct it. Now, the search planes on Iwo Jima, I think they'll help. I think they already, they made the initial detection, but they don't, in my opinion, they don't, it's not like there's a radar, a good radio contact. They can't really bring them into to kill these things, as well as if the ship, the task group, has its own search assets. Now, that's my experience, my feeling, but that's my gut feeling and experience, but I could be wrong. It might be perfectly valid to use the Catalinas here to vector, give these guys intercept vectors. And it might help, but I think having escorts or having search planes in the intercepting group is probably makes it much more efficient. Okay, these are transport ships are still running for San Francisco. Here comes another group. Oh, pardon me. These guys are under protection. Good, good, good. Here comes the British group running out. I sent one group ahead. Where did I? Did I? I think I broke out one of these guys, and sent them ahead to. Where is that? Ah, here, yeah. I sent them down to provide escort for the lead ones, and I'm going to keep shedding carriers and sending them down to meet additional convoys coming in. The British carriers are very light, but I only need a pair of them in order to provide proper escort. We're quite on the Marianas. The Oilers are just about to arrive at Pagan. Here's the leading edge of the thundering herd. Nothing happened on Peleliu. We've evacuated all the aircraft, so we don't need it. I'm probably going to just leave this. I think I'll probably waste this fleet air arm. It's only got 16 aviation. It does have a command radius of 5 and can help in that sense. So it does work very well, but I think I'm just looking at the bare minimum is the 16 aviation support that we can... we just don't, it's the smallest unit I can put over here that sacrifices the least, and that's going to be 16 aviation. Okay, so here's our thundering herd. The carriers are breaking up, coming down to meet and provide escort for them. Quiet on Iniwetok. We're still jammed on Hilo all throughout the Hawaiian Island chain. We'll break, I don't think there's any loaded yet. Well, the only one that seems half loaded is the one at Hilo, really. This is the one, and now they're wasting their energy trying to load a few dick-all fuel points. Like I told you, never load the fuel. It always screws you. They could have sailed already. Could have sailed and given up the space for someone else to dock and load. The AKs are loading. Fine. There's a couple of filled-up ones already. Okay, I think we're just... For the 6200s, yeah, I'll form them up and send them on their way. We're going to form a transport group and tankers. I guess we don't have them. Okay, form, and we'll send off those 1600s to sail by themselves. There's only three ships, but, you know, I think every little bit helps. Get them a hell out of here and on their way, free up space. The longer the stream, the better, because I can they won't all be arriving at the port at the same time. We have a few tankers loaded at Pearl Harbor. I'm sending them along with a tanker. No, the tankers are fine, but the unrepped ships, I have one of them done. I'm going to send them along with the minesweepers. The minesweepers can make it by themselves, but I'm sending along just because they have the same speed. At the same time, nothing happening on the west coast, except there's a whole bunch of PT boats that came. We're going to form escort, just get them all. Oh, 50 of them. Good grief. The reason I'm going to making this click fest, I'm putting up with it, is the other PT boats are still going to be 10 more days in their refit side. If I could wait for them, I'm not in a real rush for them, but I might be. I don't know. I just don't know if I need these. So I'm going to move these over here and disband. There's no other way to do it. If I'm in the base and I hit return, it returns all the ones under repair as well. And I don't know if when they call them up in the future, if they come out damaged. I think they come out damaged, but I'm not positive. There's no ships, so nothing else other than gathering on the west coast. Nothing to do here. There's four torpedoes at an E-boat escort. Miss. Croker fires two torpedoes and hits an E-boat. Great. There's that bombardment. Oh, we get it. The cruisers do fire. The battleships. My goodness. So this looks like it's a reinforcement group heading for Chichijima. And the battleships ran into them. Okay. Annihilated them. Boarfish fires. Hit the transport. Lizardfish misses or doesn't fire. Redfish hits a transport. Lots of torpedoes, lots of targets out there. Tanker hit. Well, maybe we're getting a tanker miss. Maybe we're getting some revenge for all those submarines we lost yesterday. Night attack, Iwo Jima. Oh crap! I forgot to put the air. I forgot to put some night fighters up. Okay, my mistake. I forgot about the last night. Lizardfish hits a torpedo, hits a tanker. Bombardment Chichijima. Heavy, heavy casualties. Good stuff. We're on the way. We might just have enough ammo to wipe them out. With that new battleship group coming, a cruiser's hit. Fantastic. Great shooting. Okinoerabushima is invaded, so it looks like let's hope he brought some combat squads with him. If he only loaded support, that's going to be a pretty weak attack. Rakin fires at a tanker. Miss. Or did he fire? I don't remember. Uh-oh, Lapon. Yeah, the enemy gets even here. We hit a tanker, but the forced to the surface and butchered. Stingray. One hit, but also a tanker. Cayman hits a tanker. Flounder misses the knee boat. Gabalon takes hits but misses. Ho hits a tanker. Good job. Hits a transport. Sea Devil misses. Oh, lots of submarines to check on today. Paddle does not fire. Paddle evades. Fires four and misses. Burgall misses. Sea Dog kills a transport. Sterlet is hit by, launches torpedoes, a destroyer, but misses and gets hit in return. Another tanker hit. Wow. A day of the tankers. Blueback is hit, but survives. Blackfin hit seven times. Well, that's what you get when you miss a sub chaser. Looks like lots more coming back. Oh, the battleships. What the hell are you doing on Iwo Jima, you stupid bastards? Oh, near Hajima. Okay, good. Yeah, the I-21, okay. We hit it 15 times, but she survives. Thank goodness she did not fire. Four torpedoes fired at a destroyer, miss. Bream sinks a tanker. Stingray sinks. Ah, shucks. So two more submarines lost today. Air raid, Hajima, 12 Bettys. We have 40 fighters up. We shoot down 8. Good stuff. Nago under attack. Not the task force, but the base. Only 17 Jills attacking, but we have 175 fighters up. Only get 9, but we didn't lose any. Hajima attack. Four more Bettys. Maybe these are the ones that survived. Oh, well. 3 of them are destroyed. It looks like it was a kamikaze attack. That was a kamikaze attack that hit him the first time, too. Wow, look at that. All 4 attack and 1 gets through. The task force at Manila under attack by Sally's. 4 destroyed. Under attack by Peggy's. 1 out of 6. Look at all those fires, and we couldn't stop it. The Betty's attack again, Hahajima. Well, I think it might have been a 3 alpha that was a suicide raid last time. Maybe they're both suicide raids. 170 fighters intercept at Nago. It's an air base attack. That's okay. We can recover these much more easily. 11 enemy shot down. The task force attacked at Manila. How is he Ceyron? That's a submarine attack. A submarine float plane. Another submarine float plane. Holy cow! Singapore under attack. 3 shot down. No losses. That's getting better. Brunei, the Peggy's attack, the regiment. 10ch takes a hit. Spikefish sinks a tanker. Trutta, 3 down and sunk. We got 2 transports. He managed bravely, drove in, but sometimes I wish he had sunk the escorts, because those escorts will be around tomorrow trying to sink another. Here's the airborne division, the ground units arriving at Apari. Deliberate attack, 871-1. 2 more destroyed. The airstrikes didn't even fly today. Shock attack. Okinoerabushima captured!